The following UW360 story is made possible by the generous support of BECU. BECU, more than just money.
One million years ago, long before humans, these were the residents of the Pacific Northwest. Not elephants, but mammoths, 15 feet tall, with gigantic tusks. In 2008, the partial remains of a Columbian mammoth were discovered near Richland, Washington.
It's pretty rare to get a skeleton at all, and we usually don't even call it a skeleton until you have maybe 10% of the bones, so that's not a huge percentage. And when they excavated the mammoth, they got about 20% of the mammoth, maybe 25%. We want to bring a Washington mammoth to exhibit in the Washington State Museum, and so that was important to us.
But just 25% isn't going to get them a whole mammoth.
This is the oversized collection room where a lot of the larger fossils are kept, and a lot of the actual fossils of the Columbia mammoth are stored.
Enter a cross-disciplinary group of UW students and instructors who are working with museum staff to recreate the rest of the Richland mammoth.
And our goal was to digitally scan those and then shrink them or expand them to the right size digitally and then 3D print them to make up for the fossils that we didn't have. We had people from biology, paleontology, master's students in the museology program, mechanical engineers, electrical engineers, biomedical engineers, all involved in this program. We had students as part of the College of Engineering's vertically integrated projects program that went from freshman all the way up to PhD on the same team.
There's a whole variety of different engineers in there. And that was really, really exciting because you get to bounce all of these ideas off. And you know, there's people that are good at one thing and there's people that are good at a different thing. And you can kind of bring everyone together and come up with something that's a lot better because you're all there. I think the UW does a really great job at promoting and encouraging these kind of collaborative projects.
This is a 13 and a half hour print.
By using 3D technologies, students are able to create replicas with safer, more accurate results.
You can scan and print something and it's a lot less dangerous to the fossil than traditional molding and casting. Getting digital models, you know, that are accurate to 200th of a millimeter means you can have research viable, you know, digital copies that you can send to somebody to look at.
The two-year project is nearing the finish line. What's next?
From here, as always planned, certain professional dinosaur fabricators or mammoth fabricators will come in and take our work and actually complete the exhibit with it. And then from here, we'll work closely with the College of Engineers and the Burke Museum to see what their next priorities are.
It's been so much fun to work with the students and the professors at the University of Washington because they all have their own expertise and they're able to bring that together and look at things in ways we never would have even thought of. Just as a paleontologist, it's giving me a lot more tools to work with in the collection. No matter where you are in the world, you'll be able to explore the Burke collections.